Hello, my dear children. I hope you all are good and fit and healthy, obeying your elders and studying hard. Okay, children, I think so. So, you should be good. So, dear children, today we will study chapter 5 of our grammar book, Interrogative Sentences. But before that, we will complete the remaining exercises of our previous chapter, that is chapter number 4. Dear children, we have done the chapter negative sentences. So this exercise was left. Change the following sentences into negative sentences. We can make a sentence into negative by adding not or no. Do you remember? First, he has two sisters. He does not have two sisters. Number two, they have a spacious house. They have no spacious house. Number three, he had an office in Mumbai. He had no office in Mumbai. She is a doctor. She is not a doctor. I am a student. I am not a student. They are rich people. They are not rich people. She speaks Spanish fluently. Speaks is there, so we will write, she does not speak Spanish fluently. We ate fresh fruit. We did not eat fresh fruit. Ninth, my friends may come today. My friends may not come today. Dear children, you will add fresh here. I have not written, you will add fresh. We did not eat fresh fruit. Then number 9, my friends may not come today. Number 10, she rang the bell. She did not ring the bell. Learner's drill, this is for your practice. Write the sentences in the correct way. City nor do I live in. I do not live in a city. Next, they do not drink coffee. Third, she does not cook well. Next, fourth, she does not have a pet. Number 5, he does not like milk. Number 6, she cannot read French. Number 7, he does not like pizza. Number 8, they do not swim every morning. Now children, this 5th chapter, interrogative sentences. Dear children, you have studied interrogative sentences. What are interrogative sentences? Sentences that ask something. They are called interrogative sentences. So let us read the following sentences: affirmative sentences, statements, and interrogative sentences. Now try to understand, try to listen carefully, and see how affirmative sentences are converted into interrogative sentences. This is her bicycle. Is this her bicycle? Question mark. Interrogative sentences, always we have to put the question mark. When question has been asked, then put the question mark. Number 2, they were eminent painters. Were they eminent painters? Question mark. You can drive this car. Can you drive this car? Question mark. Guest will arrive tomorrow. Will guest arrive tomorrow? Question mark. She will knit this sweater. Will she knit this sweater? Question mark. So children, the sentences on the left hand side state or express something. These. So they are called, such sentences are called assertive sentences. So this is the definition of assertive sentences. What are assertive sentences? The sentences that state or express something are called assertive sentences. These are the examples you can give. And the sentences on the right hand side ask something. Such sentences are called interrogative sentences or questions. This is the definition for interrogative sentences. A question mark is placed at the end of an interrogative sentence. Now read the following sentences. The moon shines at night. Does the moon shines at night? He gets a small salary. Does he get a small salary? All kinds of people live in Delhi. Do all kinds of people live in Delhi? The girl laughed. Did the girl laugh? The driver stopped the bus. Did the driver stop the bus? Now children, you should learn, you should remember this thing. The interrogative sentence in present simple are past simple tenses formed with. Now present simple and past simple tense, how the interrogative sentences are formed? See, do or does plus subject plus base form of the verb, present simple. Now see the example here. First example, the moon shines at night. Shines, so shines is there, ing for shine is there, so we will write does plus subject. Subject is the moon and shines becomes shine at night, question mark. Clear? Then in past simple, did plus subject plus base form of the verb. For example, the girl laughed is past simple, so we will make interrogative by writing did plus subject. The subject is the girl and the base form of the verb. Laughed will become laugh. Now read the following sentences. He is writing a letter. He is writing a letter. This is present participle, children, ing form. Okay? Be attentive, ing form. Is he writing a letter? Number two, I am doing my work. Am I doing my work? Number three, they are going abroad. Are they going abroad? Question mark. He was making a noise. Was he making a noise? They were bathing in the river. Were they bathing in the river? Dear children, just listen carefully. The interrogative sentences in present continuous and past continuous tenses is formed with. How we form this? In present continuous, we write am or is or are, then subject, then present participle ing form. Okay, see the example. He is writing a letter. Is there? So we will begin with is, then subject he, then present participle writing a letter. Okay, then are is there? They are going abroad. Are plus subject they plus present participle going abroad. Then for past continuous, we use was or were plus subject plus present participle ing form. For example, he was making a noise. Was, then subject he, then present participle making a noise. Were, then subject they, then present participle bathing in the river. Is that clear, children? General rules for making interrogative sentences, questions. Children, please be attentive and try to understand. Alright, then if you will be able to understand it, you will be able to do your work yourself. Okay, so be attentive and listen carefully. Number one, the helping verb comes before the subject. and the main verb comes after the subject. Let me explain you with this example. The train is subject, is helping verb, arriving main verb at the station. So our sentence is, the train is arriving at the station. This is the sentence. Okay, now subject, helping verb, main verb. What we studied here, the helping verb comes before the subject. Subject is the train and helping verb is. So is will come before. So we will write is, then the subject, the train, then arriving, that is our main verb, at the station. It becomes interrogative sentence, question mark. Clear, children? Second rule is, children, we use the question words. What, where, when, why, which, who, whom, whose and how in the interrogative sentences to ask for information. Question words are placed in the beginning of the sentences. Now see example, where are you going? Question word, helping verb, subject and main verb. Now exercises A, change the following sentences into interrogative sentences. He is a renowned painter. Now helping verb, is will come first, then subject, then a renowned partner. Is he a renowned painter? Question mark. They are famous sportsperson. Are they famous sportsperson? Question mark. William Wordsworth was a great poet. Was William Wordsworth a great poet? Question mark. He gave her a piece of advice. Did he give her a piece of advice? Number 5. The train departed very late. Did the train depart very late? He was suffering from diabetes. Was he suffering from diabetes? The girls have gone to their homes. Have the girls gone to their homes? Question mark. This is her sweater. Is this her sweater? Question mark. Her elder brother came yesterday. Did her elder brother come yesterday? Question mark. They are at home. Are they at home? Question mark. Exercise B. Complete the following sentences with question words given in the help list. First, dash pen is this. Whose pen is this? Dash book do you want to buy? Which book do you want to buy? Dash is your father's name. What is your father's name? Dash, do you want to meet? Whom do you want to meet? Dash, did you solve this problem? How did you solve this question? Dash, do you come late every day? Why do you come late every day? Dash, will the train arrive at the station? When will the train arrive at the station? Dash, is their residence? Where is their residence? Dash, are these strangers? Who are these strangers? Dash, money do you have? How much money do you have? Learner's Rest, this is for your practice, children. Write the questions. He lives in India. Where does he live? Question mark. Does he live in India? You read a lot. Do you read a lot? Third, she cooks well. Does she cook well? How does she cook? Fourth, she walks her dog every evening. Does she walk her dog every evening? When does she walk her dog? Fifth, he likes coffee. Does he like coffee? What does he like? She can read English. Can she read English? What can she read? Question mark. You like pizza. Do you like pizza? What do you like? 8. They play football every day. Do they play football every day? What do they play every day? Question mark. So, my dear children, with this we have completed our 5th chapter. Dear children, revise the chapter. Do all the exercises that we have done in book and write the definitions in your notebook with examples. Study well, learn well, obey your parents, be good children. May God bless you all.